resist the way I feel. You're a fast shooting thrill, while also the sharpest chill. We met last summer on the 4th of July. Since then I felt so high, like fireworks in the sky. I think about you in the morning, during the day and night. Sometimes I don't sleep unless you're by my side. When I open my eyes and you're next to my arms, I feel invincible, like I can never be harmed. My family is alarmed, thinks we're moving too quick. Concerned with how hooked I get, but they don't know shit. You make every worry in my world disappear. Then magically you appear and take away all my fears. It's crystal clear, you're out of this atmosphere. The type of love that'll make your parents fear. The way you make me better when I'm under the stormy weather is something I will treasure forever and ever.
I keep wondering what I'm gonna do without you. To be the first to say goodbye.
Been about a month since our first date. The old me you helped amputate, I've even lost a little weight. I swear, you know me so well. The things people say about you are lies I can tell. You used to fuck with my cousin and a couple of my boys. They treated you like wreck toys and claimed the life you destroyed. They don't know you like I do, they have a biased point of view. I don't care who you screwed, my love for you is true. Just for your taste, I'm willing to erase and disgrace anything or anyone in my way. I will say fuck it all. I'll brawl, crawl, or climb the tires while addicted to you. I don't care who's appalled. I was warned about you back in elementary school, but I dared to be different, like two points of view. What don't kill you can only make you stronger. Or maybe it makes your misery last longer, I ponder.
I keep wondering what I'm gonna do without you. To be the first to say goodbye.
6 months together, damn, time flies. Comes as no surprise, people are asking me why. Do you keep going back? I say old habits die hard. All the journeys we've embarked had me feeling higher than a star. I'm starting to question, no, who you really are. Would you even give a fuck if I entirely fell apart? A moment of clarity left me feeling cold and dry. I'm gonna have to learn to get by alone, one day at a time. Regain the trust of people in my heart. Thinking back now, I can't recall what we met in the start. Wait, it was my doctor who introduced me to you. Said if we hooked up, you could help me get through all the pain in my life. Well, I guess they were kinda right. They've been prescribing me to you since, one at a time. Now I'm a drug addict with a habit stuck trying to kick. Addicted to some shit that's way too easy to get.
My son, Christopher Parado, was 20 years old when he was prescribed opioids. It took him 5 days to get addicted. I'm not supposed to be the one to go get his suit and tie and pick which sneakers that I'm gonna bury him. My son overdosed at the age of 22 years old.
Finally tonight, a stark new report shows the opioid crisis seems to be deepening across the country. The Centers for Disease Control released data showing overdoses are increasing at an alarming rate. In fact, emergency room visits for suspected overdoses rose by an average of 30% in a year.
The first time I ever took prescription opioids is when I got my wisdom teeth taken out. I think I was 16 years old. I must have gotten a 30-day script. I took them all in 3 days. I was stealing from people, buying substances on the street. And I look back at that time with a lot of shame. You know, that's not why.
Before Chloe's family, there was another Kanata family grieving the loss of a child.
18-year-old Teslin Russell was found dead in her family's home on December 30th.
He was given a prescription opioid pain medication that lasted a lot longer than the pain itself. At the time, I didn't understand the dangers of these drugs, and within only a few months, I was completely addicted. I lost everything.
How do we not go after the number one organization? In the height of the epidemic, when people are dying everywhere, doesn't somebody have to be held accountable? McKesson needs to be held accountable.
Holding McKesson accountable meant going after the fifth largest corporation in the country. Headquartered in San Francisco, McKesson has 76,000 employees and earns almost $200 billion a year in revenues, about the same as ExxonMobil. Since the 1990s, McKesson has made billions from the distribution of addictive opioids.